Good morning, students. In last class, we have discussed about some basics of the biology, and as well as we have seen about the different branches of biology. So in today's class, we are going to discuss about some basics regarding the topic that is in cell biology. So you might have already studied in lower class about the different types of cells like prokaryotic cells and eukaryotic cells. So in today's class, we'll discuss about some basics about the cell. So already you might have studied in lower classes. So what is a cell? So if you see the definition of a cell, so cell is a structure and function unit of life. Okay. So cell is a structure and function unit of life. So several functions takes place within the cell, and every cell has its own structure. So because of that reason, it is defined as structure and function units of the life. So you might be knowing about a neuron cell. So how a neuron cell appears. Similarly, you can see about the stomata. So the cells of the stomata start with different. Similarly, the neurons in humans, there are different shapes. So they have different structure, different shape, and they have their own functions. That is the reason it is given the definition as structural and functional unit of the life. So before that, going to detail about the cell. So who has discovered this cell? So there are two discoveries generally initially given, like in dead cell, the cell was first discovered by Robert Hooke. So what is the dead cell in which Robert Hooke has discovered? The dead cell is nothing but the cork cell. So he has taken the cork cell and he has examined the cork cell under the compound microscope, and he has found that some cells are present, and those are nothing but the dead cells, and the first discovery for the cell was given to the Robert Hooke. So living cells are also discovered. So living cells also discovered by a renowned scientist, that is Anton von Leeuwenhoek. So from where he has discovered this living cell? So he has taken the scum of the teeth. So on the teeth we can find some bacteria. Every morning if you see, you check, you find some bacteria that is called the scum of the teeth. So that teeth, that scum from teeth he has extracted and he has observed under his compound microscope, and he has identified that some organisms are present, and he labeled them as living cells. At the time, we don't know that it is a bacteria, but now it is known that they are the bacteria. Similarly, he has also identified the stored rainwater, so exactly not the rainwater, because rainwater is a pure water actually. So he has observed the stored rainwater, also he has observed that some living cells are present, and that was done by the Leeuwenhoek. So now, based upon the composition of the cell, so based upon the composition of the cell, we are classifying, we will be studying the now cell in the two ways, like in the form of prokaryotic cell and as well as eukaryotic cell. So what is a prokaryotic cell and what is a eukaryotic cell? First, if you define a prokaryotic cell, it is a pro, the term pro itself is telling that it is a cell with a primitive nucleus. Whereas eukaryote, it is the cell with a well-defined nucleus, that is called as a eukaryotic cell. So now we are going to study in detail about this prokaryote as well as eukaryote and their differences. Okay students, now let us compare the difference between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So if you see on the board, so we are distinguishing the prokaryotes and eukaryotes based upon their cellular components. So let us see what are the cellular components that are present in the prokaryotes and what are the other cellular components that are present in the eukaryotes. So if you see the prokaryote, so already just now we have discussed that pro. Pro, the term itself is clearly telling that it is a primitive. The term pro indicates primitive. And a karyon means nucleus. So the cell with a primitive nucleus is known as a prokaryote. Similarly, if you see the eukaryotes, the term itself is telling you, EU. U means it is the true. The cell with the true nucleus is called as eukaryote. So based upon the name itself is telling that prokaryote and eukaryote. So prokaryote means the cell which is having primitive nucleus, whereas eukaryote means the cell which is having a well-defined nucleus. So well-defined nucleus means what are the components it is having. To tell that it is a well-defined nucleus, we are going to study there is a particular table now. So now let us compare the cell wall composition of the prokaryotes with eukaryotes. If you see the cell wall composition, you can easily find out the difference between the prokaryotes and eukaryotes. In the cell wall of the prokaryotes, it is chemically composed of sugars, or it is called, sugars are also called as carbohydrates, and it is also having some amino acids. So if you see the sugars, So there are some specialized sugars called N-acetylglutaric acid and N-acetylglucosamine, and we discussed in detail when we studying in the intermediate at the time. Now we see that cell wall composition of prokaryote, it is composed of sugars and as well as amino acids. And if you see the composition of eukaryotes, if you see the plants, so plant is having a thick cell wall, and it is made up of the major component of the cell wall is cellulose. And in case of animals, cell wall is totally absent. So instead the animal cell is protected by a specialized membrane that is called as a cell membrane. So let us compare the cell membrane present in the prokaryotes with the eukaryotes. So cell membrane has another name, it is also called as a plasma membrane, it is also called as a plasma lemma. So if you see here also in prokaryotes also we have cell membrane, similarly in eukaryotes also we have the cell membrane. So specifically, so in eukaryotes also we are having the cell membrane. So in eukaryotes also we have the cell membrane. So both are having made up of same chemical composition. It is made up of, so the cell membrane is made up of lipids and proteins. So similarly in eukaryotes also cell membrane is present and it is made up of lipids and proteins. Or it is also called as, sometimes in some books they write, it is also called as lipoproteins. So lipids and proteins are present. So the cell membrane is made up of lipids and as well as proteins. So let us see the cytoplasmic components. So we will compare the cytoplasmic components that are present in the prokaryote with the cytoplasmic components present in the eukaryotes. So the cytoplasm. So apart from the nucleus, the other fluid present in the cell is called as a cytoplasm. Means with other than the nucleus, the similar components present inside the cell is called as a cytoplasm. So what are the cytoplasmic components? So generally, the different cytoplasmic components like endoplasmic reticulum, Golgi bodies, lysosomes, mitochondria, and like ribosomes, and they are all present. So let us see whether endoplasmic reticulum is present in prokaryote or eukaryote. So if we compare the prokaryote and eukaryote, endoplasmic reticulum is absent in case of the prokaryote. That is the reason why it is called as a primitive cell. Not only endoplasmic reticulum, the Golgi bodies are also absent, and lysosomes are also absent, mitochondria is also absent. So first let us see about endoplasmic reticulum. So endoplasmic reticulum is absent in the prokaryotes, but endoplasmic reticulum is present in the eukaryotes. Now what is the function of this endoplasmic reticulum in eukaryotes? If you see the functions of endoplasmic reticulum in eukaryotes, the main function of endoplasmic reticulum is synthesis of lipids and proteins. So synthesis of lipids and proteins in eukaryotes is done with help of the endoplasmic reticulum, but it is absent in case of the prokaryotes. Similarly, if you see the Golgi bodies are also absent in the prokaryotes, but Golgi bodies are present in the eukaryotes. And if you see the major function of the Golgi bodies is packaging of the material. So packaging of material is a major function of the eukaryotes. Similarly, you see the lysosomes. So lysosomes are totally absent in prokaryotes, but lysosomes are present in the eukaryotes. And these lysosomes are also, specifically they are present in the animal cell. In case of the plants, the lysosomes are absent. Instead of lysosomes, the other organelles are also present. So let us discuss about the mitochondria. So in lower classes, you have studied that mitochondria is called as a powerhouses of the cell. So this powerhouses of the cell, why it is called a powerhouse of cell? Because it is mainly involved in respiration process like aerobic respiration. But it is absent in case of the prokaryotes. Then if the mitochondria is absent in prokaryotes, then how do mitochondria will undergo respiration? So prokaryotes undergo respiration with help of a specialized organelle that is called as a mesosome. So mesosomes plays an important role in the respiration of the aerobic respiration of the prokaryotes. So whereas in case of eukaryotes, so no doubt mitochondria is present, so respiration takes place in the case of the eukaryotes inside the mitochondria. So these are the different components. And there are some other components. Now we are going to continue that. Okay students, let us continue with the comparison between the prokaryotes and eukaryotic cellular components. So let us discuss about the other cellular organ that is called as a chloroplast. So you might be already know about the chloroplast. So this chloroplast, if you see prokaryotes, chloroplast in prokaryotes, it is absent. But there are some exceptional places where chloroplast is present. In case of the bacteria such as cyanobacteria, or it is also called as blue-green algae. So cyanobacteria has another name, it is called as a blue-green algae. So these cyanobacteria and the blue-green algae, these are the only phototropic bacteria, means they undergo the process of photosynthesis. That's why they're called as a phototropic bacteria. They undergo photosynthesis and prepare the food materials. So photosynthesis is the major event that is taking place in the plants. So that is the reason plants are having the chloroplast. So inside the chloroplast, there is a specific pigment is present. The name of the pigment is called as chlorophyll. So specifically chlorophyll B. So chlorophyll B is the chief pigment that is present inside the leaves of the plant. Because of this reason, the leaves appear green in color. So the green color of the leaf is because of the presence of the chlorophyll B pigment that is present inside the chloroplast. So within the chloroplast, where this chlorophyll pigments are present means, so within the chloroplast, so in the cytoplasm, they are having grana. So inside the grana you have chlorophyll. So anyhow, detailed study of the chloroplast will study in coming classes. Now let's see about the other cellular organ that is called as a ribosomes. So ribosomes are the cytoplasmic components that are present in case of both prokaryotes and as well as in the eukaryotes. In both cases you can see that ribosomes are the present. So till now we have seen all the components. So the common component that is present in both prokaryote and eukaryote is ribosome. That is the most important thing you have to remember, because ribosome is the only the common component that is present in case of both prokaryotes and eukaryotes. Similarly, we have seen cell membrane or plasma membrane. So it is a layer that is covering around the cell. That is also common. That is also present in prokaryotes as well as eukaryotes. So these are the two things which you have to remember, because in multiple choice questions they are asking which is the common cell organelle present, means it is the ribosome that is present both common in prokaryotes as well as in eukaryotes. Similarly, what is the other component which is commonly present in prokaryotes and eukaryotes, means you have to mention clearly the cell membrane, or it is called as a plasma membrane. So of course both ribosomes are present, but the type of ribosomes present in prokaryotes are totally different from the ribosomes present in the eukaryotes. So if you see the type of ribosomes present in the prokaryotes, the type of ribosomes present are called as 70S type, whereas the type of ribosomes present in eukaryotes are called as 80S type. So every ribosome, if you see the detailed structure of the ribosome it is like this. So two subunits it is having. So this subunit is called a small subunit, and this is called as large subunit. So this large subunit and small subunit is present. So 70S type of ribosomes are having two subunits. Small subunit, the smallest subunit is called as 30S subunit, and largest subunit is called as 50S subunit. Similarly, in case of eukaryotes also, you have two subunits. The smallest subunit is called as a 40S subunit, and largest subunit is called as a 60S subunit. So these ribosomes are having the two subunits, smallest and largest, and the small subunit and large subunit are binded or attached to each other with help of a specific ions that is called as a magnesium ions. So magnesium ions are essential. So if enough amount of magnesium ions are not present in the cytoplasm, then what happens? If enough amount of the magnesium ions are not present in the cytoplasm, the small subunit and large subunit do not bind to each other. They will separately present in the cytoplasm. If enough amount of magnesium ions are present, then only the small subunit will come and attach to the large subunit. Then what is the major role of these particular ribosomes in the particular cytoplasm or particular in the cell of prokaryote and eukaryote? If you see the function, is same for prokaryotes as well as eukaryotes. What is its function? Its main function is protein synthesis, to synthesize proteins. In case of prokaryotes, it is also involved in protein synthesis. In case of eukaryotes also, it is involved in the process of protein synthesis. So, but if you see the ribosomes in case of the prokaryotes, the ribosomes appear in the cytoplasm in the form of polyribosomes, which is also another name that is called as polysomes. But what is this polyribosomes means? See, so 7 and 4 like this, ribosomes will be attached. So small subunit and large subunit. So ribosomes will be attached like this, 4, 4 to 5, right? Ribosomes will be attached to a thread-like structure, and this thread-like structure is called as mRNA. So what is a polyribosome composition means? Polyribosome is made up of mRNA plus ribosomes. So the ribosomes in the cytoplasm of prokaryotes appear in the form of polyribosomes. But in case of eukaryotes, they don't exist in case as they just simply present in the cytoplasm. They scatter like this. They scatter in the cytoplasm as in this form. They are not in the polyribosomal form. But in case of prokaryotes, they are present in the polyribosomal form. So these are the components in case of prokaryotes and eukaryotes. So once again, just recap what we have discussed today in this class. So in this class, we are discussing about some basic components. We have discussed about some basic components of cell biology. We have told a cell is a structure and functional unit. And based upon the different similar components, we are distinguishing the prokaryotic cell with eukaryotic cell. So we have told that what is the definition of prokaryote. Prokaryote is pro means primitive. The cell with primitive nucleus is called as a prokaryote. The cell with a well-defined nucleus is called as eukaryotes. And we also have seen the different cellular components. So we have seen the difference between the cell wall of prokaryote with eukaryote. The cell wall of prokaryote is made up of sugars plus amino acids. Whereas in case of eukaryotes, the cell wall of plant is made up of cellulose, whereas in case of animal, the cell wall is totally absent and it is protected by cell membrane. So, and other organelles, we have seen Golgi bodies, we have seen endoplasmic reticulum, lysosomes. These all are absent in prokaryotes, but they are present in the eukaryotes. And the common cell organelle between prokaryote and eukaryote is only the ribosome. But the type of ribosomes in prokaryote and eukaryote is totally different. It is of 70S type and here it is of 80S type. Difference between the plant cell and as well as animal cell.